Aria Operations for Applications, formerly Tanzu Observability by Wavefront, provides full visibility of your entire stack. With over 250 pre-built integrations, you can observe, alert on, and react to potential service impacts regardless of where they occur. From bare metal servers to containers such as Docker and orchestration layers such as Kubernetes, whether on-prem or in the cloud, Aria can collect metrics, traces, and now logs regardless of where your infrastructure or services may live. Aria Operations for Applications makes it easy to instrument the popular cloud platforms as well, such as OpenShift, Tanzu Kubernetes Grid, Tanzu Application Platform, and many others. Here we see Aria for Applications instrumenting a microservice application called TacoCat, which sells cool t-shirts with cats. This application is a true polyglot application, and it's multi-home both on-prem and in the cloud. From this one dashboard, we can see business level metrics across the top. From the left, we see the AppDeck score, which is an industry standard measure of customer satisfaction based on response time. Then we see business metrics such as completed and lost sales. In this case, these figures are estimates based on average cart size. Continuing, we see transaction rate along with error rates, and this demonstrates how Aria for Applications can provide business level metrics in addition to the full tech stack. Below that, we see platform metrics. In this case, we're seeing the Kubernetes layer. Notice that we can see the same view, regardless if we're viewing the on-prem, TKG, or cloud instances. Aria for Application is great for all platforms. Below that, we see the customer experience as measured by Catchpoint Synthetics. Here we can see average transaction time, the slowest nodes, and a histogram of response times over the past week. This really illustrates the different ways we can visualize data to make it meaningful to you. Below that, we come to the services that make up TacoCat. We can see the services and their relative health, any firings of alerts, and the average response time of these back-end services. From here, we can easily navigate to a view showing the health of the underlying platform. This dashboard lets us view the health of all of our Kubernetes clusters. Looks like we have 6 clusters under surveillance. Notice we can change the focus from all to any, regardless of whether that cluster is on-prem, in the cloud, on TKG, or bare metal Kubernetes. Also notice this includes our TAP cluster as well. If we don't find what we're looking for here, we can easily return to the overview and from there navigate to see the tracing collected from these services. This is our traces browser. On the left, we see all of the spans collected during this time frame. Continuing clockwise, we see a mini map of the services interaction. This is important because many times the agent investigating a potential service impact may not be familiar with the app and underlying services. Continuing, we see our red metrics, request, error, and duration or latency. And in the middle, we see the spans that make up the trace highlighted in the left panel. From here, we can dig in to see or determine the cause of our potential service impact. If we refocus on our payment service, we can see failed transactions, and digging a little deeper, we can see a span log showing payment authorization has timed out. This is very cool, and let's say we wanted to get our peer on the engineering team involved to look at the span log. This is made easy using the link icon on the bottom right. Just click the link and copy and Slack it to our peer, and they're looking at the same view. Aria Operations for Applications has added logs, providing unified observability. With metrics, logs, and traces, you have a unified solution that you can use across your organization. Let's continue our investigation and dive into our logs. There are different ways to navigate to our logs, from the menu at the top or from a contextual link. Here we see an application map of our TacoCat application, and from here we can dive into logs with a focus on the selected service. This is our logs browser. Notice that we have navigated here in context of the application instance and service we clicked on. We can further investigate by searching for the error we saw earlier. And now perhaps we want to zoom out to see how frequently this has been occurring. Looking at the past 24 hours, we can see it's occurring many times per hour. Perhaps now we might want to focus in on a narrow time and see what else was happening around that same time frame. We can remove existing filters and then filter out services that are not useful to our investigation. And now we can start to get an idea of what was going on that led to the error we observed earlier. Now let's look at the features of logging in general. So we're going to clear our filters and look back at the past 2 hours. On the left, we can choose to filter by tags such as application, container name, or service, just to name a few. As we view the logs, notice the highlighted log level. When we can detect that in the log, we'll show that here. I can also view all the logs tagged as coming from an app, and then group them into a histogram at the top to see what's generating the most logs. I can see Demo Shop is generating more logs than 2 instances of Taco Cat, so I can continue to focus by filtering down to Demo Shop and then grouping by service. Looks like the front end or the currency service are generating the most logs. And we're not limited to application logs. Changing a few filters, we can now see the logs from our Kate's containers running on the platform. This really just shows how easy it is to bring logs from different levels into Aria for applications. When you're ready to try logs, head on over to our docs for an overview and a tutorial on how to get started.